Good morning, my name is Martin, and this is the tribe of the fox. A long, long time ago, I think it was in the 1930s, a Swiss psychiatrist called Carl Jung, he spoke about archetypes, and he spoke about the god Wotan. So that's the same as Wodan, Woden, Odin. So he spoke about Wotan as an archetype for the Germanic, or more specific, German people. So that's very interesting, because are the gods and goddesses only archetypes, or are they also realities? Now, I think that the gods and goddesses are archetypes and realities. So if you have another opinion, then please write it down in the comment section below. Because by comparing different viewpoints, you can acquire wisdom. That's a nice thing of the comment section, no? It's like a thing place, like a meeting place, like our ancestors had. Yeah, we can share wisdom. So yeah, archetypes or realities. You know, there are all kinds of natural phenomena like life, death, fertility, rain, storm. If you give them a face, so to speak, if you personify them, then you create the gods and goddesses. So they are realities, but the way they exactly look is determined by the people who give them that face, if you understand what I mean. So what's most interesting, I believe that they are both realities and archetypes, the deities, but I want to speak more about their archetypical role, just like Carl Jung did. So the Teutonic people, the Germanic people, but also the Celtic people, the Slavic people, the Baltic people, they have a whole pantheon of deities. That makes sense, because there's so many natural phenomena. And there are also so many people in a tribe. Not everyone thinks the same way. So by seeing the gods and goddesses as archetypes, that teaches you a lot about yourself. So that's a great thing. For instance, the deity that I work with most is Hel. And Hel, or Hela, she also called, she rules the realm of the dead. So she's a bit of a reclusive deity. And, you know, I love to hang out at graveyards. I mean, the regular viewers already know that, and I also shot some videos on graveyards. I really love it. I love the energy there. So that's something that I definitely have in common with the goddess Hel. Now, another deity that plays a large role in my life is Wodan. Now, Wodan is not a deity that's around all the time, in my opinion. However, I do have a lot of characteristics that Wodan also has. For instance, he was a wisdom seeker. Wodan is known, or Odin, is known as a wisdom seeker. Now, that's something that I do for so many years, for all my life actually, you know. I've been a reader of books since I was a kid. And once in my search for wisdom, I even sacrificed my normal life. I had a well-paid job, I had a beautiful 18th century home, and I sold it, I quit my well-paid job, and I left for Germany to live in a meditation center to learn more about meditation. I mean, many people love to visit meditation centers, but they don't take the step to actually live there and sell their house and quit their job. Later on in life, I even became a Buddhist monk, living in a monastery wearing a robe. So I made a lot of sacrifices. Now that's a pretty Vodanic thing to do, if you want to call it that way. Because Wodan, if you read the stories about the god Wodan or Odin, he sacrificed so much. He sacrificed one of his eyes to drink from the well of Mimir. That's by drinking from the well of Mimir, you can get a lot of wisdom. He even sacrificed himself, hanging on a tree, stabbed with a spear for 9 days and nine nights to acquire the wisdom of the runes. So yeah, I sacrificed quite a lot as well. So that's a very Wodanic thing to do. So that is something that I have in common. Now, Wodan is also a deity that's known to journey from world to world. Now, as the regular viewers know, I like to journey as well. Shamanic journeying, I mean. I don't like journeying by airplane, by the way, or by car. I hate it. But I love to make shamanic journeys. That's also very much a thing of Wodan. So both Wodan and Hel are two archetypes, if you look at them from the perspective of archetypes, who are in me. So yeah, by looking at that way, you have to basically look at yourself as well. Now another interesting thing is that there are also a bit more obscure or more dark deities. Some people already think that Hel is a dark deity. But you also have, for instance, Angerboda, the mother of Hel. She lives in the Ironwood. And that's a very wolf-like energy. I journeyed to the Ironwood, very wolf-like, werewolf-like actually. Because they're not proper wolves, they're man-wolves who live there. It's a very wild thing. A very, well, I don't say dark in a negative way, but in a way it's a bit more dark. Now that archetype is also in me, and that clashes a little bit with other archetypes. You see where I'm going now? This becomes psychology. You know, you see conflicting things in yourself. Yeah. And that's a beautiful thing actually. Yeah, I really like the Norns as well. They're also very reclusive. I have a good feeling for reclusive deities. But then again, another deity that's opposite to it, like Thor, also called Donar, that archetype also lives in me. That's an archetype of life energy going out there. Yeah, that's also there. So that seems a bit conflicting with Hel, who lives has a more dead energy, lives reclusive. Angerboda lives quite reclusive, is quite wild. And then you have Donar or Thor, who has a life energy going out there. So there you also see a bit of a conflict. It doesn't need to be a conflict, by the way. And that makes you look at yourself in a different perspective. So it's a great thing to learn about all these deities and what they are, what they represent, and then have a look inside yourself. And of course, you can go to the gods by reading about them. That's a good thing. But it's an even better thing to journey to where they live. Or just to contact them by journeying. Yeah. If you are able to do this, of course. Yeah, it's not a necessity, but it just adds a little bit more, I do have to say. It does add a little bit more. Yeah. And then things are not always what you think it is. I was reading about Angerboda on a website. It was fairly dark and with conflicts and everything. But my experience says something different. I trust my experience, and I talk with people who also shamanic journey. So then you can compare, and that adds to wisdom. And if you all have the same type of experience, roughly, then you know from, okay, I'm on the right way. So yeah, the gods as archetypes, or the goddesses, very important, very, very, very important. And Dirkje, by the way, she made a really nice video about Freya. Now, I see Freya as the archetype of the northern or northwestern European woman. Archetype, she's an archetype that is Freya, that is free. She's free, she's self-conscious, she's very feminine without being a feminist. She doesn't hate men, absolutely not. She is sexy without sluttiness. It's a very positive archetype for Teutonic women. So if you have a daughter, just teach her about Freya. And it's very important, yeah. And you can see Holla. Holla, you can see her as the archetype of a wise old woman, like a grandmother. Yeah. They have so many different characteristics, and this whole pantheon together, they make it very complete. They give a complete picture of what humans can be. We are extremely closely connected to these deities because they are realities and archetypes at the same time. That's why they are so close to us. That's why it's so easy to work with them. And that's why it's so hard to work with deities outside of your own pantheon. Yeah. I mean, I've been a Buddhist monk, as you know. In Buddhism, you have Mahayana Buddhism, for instance, you have Bodhisattvas as archetypes. But I always found it extremely hard to relate to them because they are not my archetypes. And I find it extremely easy to relate to Wodan, Hel, Donar, Angerboda, because that's in my memory. I mean, not my brain memory, but it's in my, you know, there's a much more deeper memory. Call it blood memory. Call it ancestral memory. Maybe it's even in your DNA. Just give it a name. Give it a name. I'm not going to argue over that. I call it blood memory. And these deities are in my blood memory. They are my archetypes, and probably yours too. Yeah, so, and find out what deity fits you most. Some people are more for the fertility deities, like Freya, Donar. Other for Hela and Holla. Some people are even more into what we call the giants, the Jotun. Yeah. That's also possible. That depends on who you are. So this is all interesting stuff to think about. And let me know. Let me know in the comment section with what deities you are working. And how is that to work with those deities? And what do you exactly do? I think it's very interesting. I already told you a lot in the videos that I have made. And Dirkje has also told you a lot about the videos that she made about Holla and Freya. She has a great connection with those two deities. So let me know what your favorite deities are. So yeah, it's already almost 15 minutes, I see. So I'm gonna finish this video. I'm going to finish it by saying thank you for watching. I hope you comment, like the video, subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, and stay safe. Stay healthy and see you in the next video. Bye bye.